Today's topic is crystal lattice. First of all, let us discuss what does it mean by the lattice. Lattice is basically just an arrangement. It is arrangement of points. See, I will take over here. If you arrange some points like this, any of these points. So, if you are arranging the points, that arrangement of the points is called as the lattice. And this arrangement of the points, if you are doing three-dimensionally means a space, you know, x direction, y direction, z direction. If you are arranging these points three-dimensionally, then such type of the arrangement is called as the three-dimensional arrangement or space lattice. I am repeating this one. Lattice is nothing but the arrangement of the points. If these points are arranged in a sequential order, then that is also known as the lattice, and these points are called the lattice points. Lattice points, and the positions are called as the lattice positions. Okay. And if these points are arranged three-dimensionally, then that is called as the space lattice. So, if these points are arranged repeatedly in the space in a three-dimensional manner, that is called as the space lattice. Now, I'll see here, let us try to connect these points with one another. See, I am going to connect these points like this. See, I am going to connect these points, and here also if you connect these points, I will keep this one here, 1 minute. So, imagine here a point is there. Now, I am going to connect all these points. Now, again you can put the points like that only here. There is chance to keep the points like this. Means whatever the points are there in the first layer resembles the points in the remaining layers. See here, whatever the arrangement is, that the same arrangement you can see over here, and the same arrangement we are observing here also. Okay. Now you connect these points, you will get the one hexagonal structure like this. You got it or not? Hexagonal structure. And the same structure again we are repeating here. See, if we connect it here, again we will get the another hexagonal structure. So, you can move on like this. If you imagine this is an A layer, this layer resembles this one. So, this is also called as the A layer. And this structure also same as in the case of the earlier two. So, it is also called as the A layer. So, it is having the A type of the arrangement. So, lattice basically says about only the arrangement of the points. If these points are arranged in the space in a three-dimensional structure, because here you can see three-dimensionally. So, such type of the arrangement of the points in a three-dimensional manner is called as the space lattice. When these points are connected to the one another, we got a particular shape. So, the geometry of the space lattice is called the crystal lattice here. So, crystal lattice basically says that here, if these points, whatever the points I said, these points may be the molecules, or these points may be the ions, or these points may be the atoms. See, if you take the NaCl ionic crystal, so NaCl ionic crystal is having the two types of the ions, Na plus ions and Cl minus ions. So, in the case of the NaCl, what happens? One of these position will be occupied by the Na plus ion, and the next position will be occupied by the Cl minus ion. And here it will be the Na plus ion, and here it shall be the Cl minus ion. And so, in the case of the NaCl, these are the ions. So, we can say these are the ions. But if you take the iodine molecule, so each position shall be occupied by the one of the iodine molecule like this. All these positions are occupied by the iodine molecule in the case of the molecular solids. And in the case of the covalent solids, just like diamond, whatever it may be, these positions shall be occupied by the atoms. So, depending on the type of the particles that are occupying these positions, the name of the crystal depends only on the type of the particles present in those positions. So, every time we cannot use the word molecules, ions or atoms. So, a common word we use to represent these particles, that is constituent particles. So, constituent particle basically says it may be the molecule, it may be the ion, it may be the atoms. In the case of the molecular solids, this constituent particle says about the molecules. In the case of the ionic solids, it says about the ions. In the case of the covalent solids, it says about the atoms. So, crystal lattice basically a three-dimensional arrangement of the constituent particles is called as the crystal lattice. Hope you understand. Now, let us move on to the another important word, that is unit cell. So, unit cell means it is the, I will write down the definition, it is the three-dimensional repeating unit. Unit of crystal lattice. So, it is the smallest, I forgot word here, it is the smallest three-dimensional repeating unit of the crystal lattice. We know the wall is constructed by using the bricks. So, if you imagine this is the complete wall, I will take the line properly. So, if you use this is the wall, if you think this is the wall, so this is constructed by using the bricks. And whatever the structure of the wall is there, the same structure is with the brick. So, brick almost represents the structure of the wall. And similarly, in the case of the crystals also, the smallest repeating unit of the crystal is known as the unit cell. I will take the one of the cubical structure here. So, this is one cubical structure. And in this cubical structure, we can write n number of the cubes, means using the same type of the cubical structure. Now, you connect this cubical structure, you try to extend this one to the other side. Now, see, this unit is again repeated here. The same structure we can construct again over here. We can construct it here till here. Just see. Similar structure. See, the same unit is repeated again here. We can construct one more unit cell or crystal. See, finally, the entire crystal structure is resemblance of the smallest unit of the crystal. So, the smallest unit of the crystal that resembles the entire crystal is called the unit cell. So, if you are studying about the unit cell, it will give the complete characteristics of the complete crystal, because the structure properties, all the properties of the unit cell are always equal to the properties of the crystalline structure. So, this is a crystalline structure which is made up of the smallest repeating units. Now, let us see the characteristics of the unit cell. So, any crystal or unit cell can be studied by using some properties, some characters. I will take them here. Just make them join these lines and here this line. Now, we know this is an x-axis, this is an y-axis, this is a z-axis, okay? And this edge is called as A, this edge is called as B, and this edge is called as the C. So, any unit cell is characterized by using the three edges A, B and C. This A, B and C, they may be equal, they may not be equal. And the angles between the A and B is called as gamma, and this is called as alpha, and this is called as the beta. This is compulsorily we have to remember, these are fixed values. Don't try to start the angle between the A and B as an alpha. It is always gamma. Gamma next alpha, beta, gamma, like this. Okay. So the unit cell, any unit cell can be understood, its structure, properties, everything can be understood by these three edges A, B, C, and angles alpha, beta, and gamma. So these are called the characteristics of the unit cell. So based on the A, B, C, means the length of the A may be equal to the B and C, or they may not be equal. So based on the A, B, C edge lengths and the angles between the alpha, beta, and gamma, the unit cells are further classified. And before that, let us try to see type of unit cells. Unit cells are of actually two types. Basically, they are primitive unit cells. Everybody has to remember this. Primitive unit cell, it is also known as the simple unit cell, simple cubic unit cell. And the second part is, I'll write here, centered unit cells. So we shall try to know what does it mean by the primitive unit cell or simple cubic unit cell. So I am going to write down the complete characteristics of the primitive unit cell or simple cubic unit cell. First of all, let's try to draw the structure. This is the simple unit cell or primitive unit cell. So in the case of the primitive unit cell, we know how many corners are there in a cube? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. All the corners of the unit cell are occupied by the constituent particles. What does it mean by constituent particle? So constituent particle may be a molecule, atom, or ion. So if all the corners of the unit cell are occupied by the constituent particles, such type of the unit cells are called the primitive unit cells. So and each position is called the lattice position, correct? So how many lattice positions are in the primitive unit cell? 8 positions are there. So lattice points are positions. Number of lattice points or positions in the primitive unit cell are how many? 8 are there. Number of particles, okay, number of positions only. 8 positions are there. And what other characteristics are there? Actually, it looks like that there is a gap between these two, every of these unit cells. But actually, there is no gap among these particles. Actually, the particles arranged like this. See, this is one unit cell. So not unit cell, one particle, and this is the next particle. Means say these two are those particles. So there is no gap. Actually, to represent to for a better understanding, we are writing like this. Actually, there is no gap. They are in touch with each other. And this particle appears here. And this particle appears here. Like this. And similarly, these two particles I am going to write here, and this particle, okay, and this particular particle appears here, and this particle obviously will appear over here. Now let us try to join the center of these particles. See, this is the center of this particle, and this is the center of this particle, and this is the center of this particle, and this is the center of this particle. Now join these four centers, we get this structure like this, and this is the center of this particle, center of this particle. Imagine those are their respective centers, and these are those centers, and you join them also like this. Now you connect these. we got exactly cubical structure or not. So basically in the solid there are no lines. Lines are only for our understanding purpose. Lines do not exist, only the particles exist. By joining the center of those particles, then we can get the shape. That shape is called the primitive unit cell here. So primitive unit cell is having the 8 corners and each corner is occupied by the one of the particle. Now let's try to calculate the effective number of the particles. So how many particles are present in this primitive unit cell? It looks like that 8 particles are there. So actually these 8 particles belong to the unit cell or not? Actually 8 particles are not completely belongs to the this particular cube. So if only single cube is there, then each particle is completely belong to this particular cube. Then what happens? Actually we have already studied that a crystal is formed by the combination of so many unit cells like this. So one unit cell is always connected with the adjacent unit cell in a three dimensional manner. This direction, front, back, top also. Similarly here also, you just see, if we connect this unit cell with the another unit cell like this, now earlier this particle is completely belong to this unit cell, now it is shared between the two unit cells, right? And similarly you just see, we shall take one more here. You just connect it to the front. Now it is shared among how many cubes? This is the one cube, front cube, this is the basic cube, second, and this is the third one. So three cubes. And now you can develop one more cube here. So it is shared among how many cubes? 1, 2, 3, 4. So its contribution towards each unit cell is only 1/4. 1/4 belongs to this side, 1/4 belongs to this side, 1/4 this side, 1/4 this side. So this is from the single layer. And you can develop the similar cube on top also, because 4 are here and 4 you can develop on the top like this. Then it is shared among the 8 cubes or not? 4 from the bottom side and 4 from the top like this if you connect. So this particular point is shared among the 8 unit cells. So each point means 8 points are there. Each point is contributing only 1/8 part. So 8 points are there. Each point is contributing how much part? Only 1/8 part. So if you cancel 8, so only one unit cell means one point is completely. Effective number of atoms present in the simple cubic unit cell are only one atom. Means from this particular point we get 1/8 part. From this particular point 1/8 part. So if you add all these 1/8 parts from 8 unit cells, the number of effective number of atoms that present in the primitive unit cell are only 1. So not 8 points. 8 points are there, but number of particles, effective number of particles are only 1. Effective number of particles means the actual number of particles present within a single unit cell are equals to 1. Why? Because 8 particles are there, but from each particle it is contributing only 1/8. 1/8 part of each particle belongs to this one. So number of effect number of atoms in the primitive unit cell are only 1. Now let us see the centered unit cell. So what is the difference between the primitive unit cell and centered unit cell? Primitive unit cell contains particles only at the corners. Then what about the centered unit cell? Centered unit cells contains the particles not only at the corners, but other positions of the unit cell also. So let us see what are those. These centered unit cells are of again different categories. They are face centered unit cells. Second one, body centered unit cell. Third one, end-centered unit cell. So, I will discuss the body-centered unit cell first, because it becomes easy to us to make you understand. So, you take one unit, one cube like this. Imagine this is a perfect cube. And here also same cube I will try to draw. And here also I will draw the same type of the cube. So, they are almost the same. Now, in the case of the body centered unit cell, we know that here the corner, these are the corners, each corner is occupied by a particle, constant particle in all these centered unit cells. Here also same. Here also same. Now, centered unit cells, in all the centered unit cells, the particles are present at the corners, just like in the primitive unit cell. Then what is the difference between the centered unit cells and primitive unit cells is, in the case of the body centered unit cell, the particles not only present at the corner of the cube, but also present at the center of the body of the cube. Center of the body of the cube. So, body centered, that is why it is called the body centered unit cell. Then what does it mean by face centered unit cell? So, in this case of the face centered unit cell, the particles not only present at the corner of the unit cell, but also at the center of each face. How many faces are there in a cube? This is one front face and this is back face. And this is a left side edge, this is the right side face. So, front, back, left, right, four are there. Now, this is the top face and this is the bottom face. So, six faces are there. Now, try to put one particle at the center of each face. So, I will select the front face. This is the front face. So, this shall be the center of the front face. And select the left side face. So, this is the center of the left side face. And now, select the back side face. This is the center of the back side face. And select the top side face. This is the center of the top side face. And select the bottom side face. Here the center of the bottom side face. And select the right hand side face and this is that center. So, in the case of the face centered unit cells, the constant particles not only present at the corner of the cube, but also present at the center of the each face. Now, come to the end centered unit cell. And in the case of the end centered unit cell, the particles not only present at the corner of the cube, but also present at the center of any two opposite faces. End center, no? So, either we have to take these two ends or left right ends or front back ends. So, I am picking up the top and the bottom ends. So, this is the top face center and this is the bottom face end. So, the particles are present any two ends, center of the face of the any two ends. So, you can select either this side or top, front and back. Only two faces you have to select, the two opposite faces, not side by side faces. So, these are called the centered unit cells. So, centered unit cell basically having the particles not only at the corners, but at the other places also. So, if the other place is the center of the body, then it is called the body centered unit cell. If other place is the center of the each face, then it is called the face centered unit cell. If the that centers are the two opposite faces, then it is called the end centered unit cell. Now, let us try to calculate how many number of the lattice points are present, what about the Z effective number. So, I shall try to do that now here. First of all, number of particles, number of lattice positions. How many lattice positions are there in the face center? 8 corners are there plus 6 faces are there. 8 plus 6 equals to 14. And here a number of lattice positions are equals to 8 corners are there plus 1 body center. That equals to 9 total positions. I am not saying about the effective number. I am saying about the only positions. And in this case, lattice positions are equals to 8 corners are there plus 2 opposite faces. So, equals to totally 10 positions are there. Now, let us try to calculate the effect number of the particles. Effect number means total contribution of each particle towards only one cube. See, we have already calculated if any particle is present at the corner of the cube, its contribution towards a particular cube is only 1/8 part. Like that, here how many are there? 8 particles are there. So, 8 into, I will write it from corners first of all. I will write down that also, Z effect number from corners. From corner particles, there are 8 particles. Each particle contribute only 1/8 part, like that 1 are there. And what about the faces? Faces means if you try to connect like this, this particular face, whatever this face is there, it is shared between this A and B, two cubes. Means this particle half belongs to this side, half belongs to this side. So, from faces, how many faces are there? 6 faces are there. Each face centered particle is contributing how much of its part towards a particular cube? Half. So, each particle is giving only half towards a particular cube. So, like that 3. Total number of effect number of particles in face centered unit cell are 3 plus 1 equals to 4. Similarly, body centered. So, from corner, 8 corners are there. Each one contribution is only 1/8 upon, like that 1. And from body center. Body center means it is center of the body, so completely belongs to this cube only. It is not shared with the any other unit cell. So, from body center, one particle is there. That one particle 100% belongs to the same cube, so 1. So, total number of effect number of particles from the body center are 2. Now, let us take the end center. So, from corner. How many corner atoms are here? 8 are there. Each is contributing only 1/8 part. So, completely one particle is coming from all 8 corners. And from faces, from two opposite faces. So, 2 are there. And face centered particle, how much contribution is there? Only half. 2 into half equals to 1. So, like that, 2 particles are there. So, effective number of particles in the primitive unit cell are 1, whereas face centered unit cell are 4, body centered 2, and end centered are 2. So, this is the calculation of the effect number of particles. So, lattice points are different from the effective number of particles. Effect number of particles is the actual contribution of each particle towards a particular cube. Lattice points represents only the number of positions occupied by the particles. So, number of positions occupied by the particles means this is the way all the particles we have to calculate. But effect number means from each particle how much contribution is coming to the cube, that is called as the effect number of the particles. So, this is about the type of the unit cells. Thank you students for joining today's session. Hope you understand in calculation of the lattice positions and effect number of the particles.